Have you been dreaming about a car for a long time? It might be a worthwhile idea to dream about a horse that will pull it. After all, the fossil fuels we use, and without which we can't imagine our lives, are disappearing at a breakneck pace. This encourages humanity to think about an alternative. The alternative that can change the world, and that is hydrogen. It is hydrogen which is the simplest and most common element that we undeservedly forget. Fossil fuels are hundreds of millions of years old, but consumption has increased rapidly over the last 200 years, causing fossil fuels to run out and climate change to be severely affected. The global consumption of fossil fuels is growing at a rapid pace, and new reserves are becoming harder to find. The reserves that are being found now are much smaller than those found in the past. Oil reserves are a good example of this, where 16 of the 20 largest fields in the world have reached peak production levels. They are just small enough to keep up with the world demand. To hold the average global temperature rise below 1.5 degrees Celsius, we need to leave up to 80% of fossil fuel reserves in the ground. However, this is nearly impossible because worldwide, our dependence on fossil fuels is only increasing. That is why humanity has a rapidly growing need for new energy sources, those that allow us to transport energy in a usable form from one place to another. Hydrogen, like electricity, is an energy source that must be produced from another substance. Besides, it has a high energy content, about 3 times more than gasoline. Hydrogen is the simplest element. A hydrogen atom consists of only one proton and one electron. It is also the most abundant element in the universe. Despite its simplicity and abundance, hydrogen is not found in nature as a gas on Earth. It is always combined with other elements. For example, water is a combination of hydrogen and oxygen, H2O. Even stars such as the Sun are composed mainly of hydrogen. The Sun is essentially a giant ball of hydrogen and helium gases. Hydrogen is found in many organic compounds, particularly the hydrocarbons, that are the components of many of our fuels, such as gasoline, natural gas, methanol, and propane. Hydrogen can be separated from hydrocarbons by using heat, a process known as reforming. Most hydrogen is now produced in this way from natural gas. Electric current can also be used to separate water into its oxygen and hydrogen components. This process is known as electrolysis. We will look at it in more detail next. Some algae and bacteria, using sunlight as an energy source, also give off hydrogen under certain conditions. Hydrogen is rich in energy. However, the engine which burns pure hydrogen almost doesn't pollute the environment. NASA has been using liquid hydrogen since the 1970s to launch space shuttles and other rockets into orbit. To use hydrogen requires a fuel cell. It combines hydrogen and oxygen to produce electricity, heat, and water. Fuel cells are often compared to batteries. Both turn the energy produced by a chemical reaction into useful electrical energy. However, a fuel cell will produce electricity as long as fuel is supplied, and hydrogen never loses its charge. Fuel cells work best with pure hydrogen, but fuels such as natural gas, methanol, or even gasoline can be processed to produce the hydrogen needed for fuel cells. Some fuel cells can even be fueled directly with methanol. If this direction is developed, in the future, hydrogen could join electricity as one of the most important energy sources. It is worth remembering that the energy source moves and delivers energy to consumers in a usable form. Renewable energy sources, such as the sun and wind, can produce energy all the time. However, they can, for example, produce electrical energy and hydrogen, which can be stored as long as it's needed. This means that hydrogen can be transported like electricity to the places where it's needed. The advantages of hydrogen energy are obvious and numerous, but the question arises, then why is hydrogen used at such an insignificant level? I suggest that we take a closer look at its advantages and try to understand what the big corporations are so afraid of, which have monopolized most of the world's fuel and electricity reserves. hydrogen is a rich source of energy. Although it may require many resources to use, no other energy source is infinite like hydrogen. What this essentially means is that it can't run out like other energy sources. Hydrogen can be produced either locally, where it will be used, or centrally, and then distributed. Hydrogen gas can be produced from methane, gasoline, biomass, coal, or water. Factors such as the amount of pollution, technical problems, and energy needs depend directly on this source. Still, it is a practically clean energy source. When hydrogen is burned to produce fuel, the byproducts are perfectly safe, which means they have no known side effects. Aviation companies actually use hydrogen as a source of drinking water. Once hydrogen is used, it is usually turned into drinking water for astronauts on spacecraft or space stations. Hydrogen energy is non-toxic, which is usually very rare for a fuel source. It is friendly to the environment and is not harmful or destructive to human health. This aspect makes it preferable to other fuel sources, such as nuclear power or natural gas, which are extremely dangerous or even scary. It also makes it possible to use hydrogen in places where other fuels might be prohibited. When hydrogen is combined with oxygen in a fuel cell, electricity is produced, which can be used to power vehicles or drive an electric motor as a heat source and for many other purposes. When it is combined with oxygen, the only byproducts are water and heat, giving hydrogen a huge advantage as an energy source. The use of hydrogen fuel cells does not emit carbon dioxide or other greenhouse gases or other particulate matter. However, this only happens when renewable sources such as water or solar energy are used in the production process, not to be confused with gasoline. Hydrogen is an efficient form of energy because it can transfer a lot of energy for every pound of fuel compared to diesel or gas. This actually means that a car that uses hydrogen energy will travel more miles than one with the same amount of gasoline. For example, compared to an ordinary combustion-based power plant, which typically produced electricity at 33 to 35% efficiency, hydrogen fuel cells can produce electricity at up to 65% efficiency, having about 3 times the capacity. Another advantage is a sustainable production system, such as electrolysis. This is a method in which water is separated into hydrogen and oxygen. This means that renewable energy can be used to power the electrolyzers. That is, to produce hydrogen from water, providing a sustainable system independent of petroleum products. This energy source doesn't pollute the environment and doesn't create emissions. Some of the renewable sources used to power the electrolyzers are wind power, hydropower, solar power, and tidal energy. Once hydrogen is produced in an electrolyzer, it can be used in a fuel cell to produce electricity. The byproducts produced by fuel cells, as was mentioned earlier, are water and heat. If the fuel cells operate at high temperatures, the system can be set up as a cogenerator with the waste energy used for heating. A great example of the advantages of hydrogen is a study described in Nature Communications. A team of researchers has developed a new way to generate energy from ordinary water. According to them, the new study shows that energy produced by evaporating water in the US lakes and reservoirs could provide up to 70% of the US electricity demand. Another interesting study was conducted in 2015 by Osgur Sahin of Columbia University. He developed a system that would extract energy from water evaporated by using bacterial spores. The team stuck Bacillus subtilis spores to a piece of tape and exposed them to water. When the water evaporated, the spores coagulated, that is, the tape would shrink, resulting in a complete seal. Simply put, it is a closed structure in which water condenses, and the cycle can repeat itself many times, and the power generated in this process can be used to create electricity. Despite the numerous advantages of hydrogen, the energy from fossil fuels still rules the world. What is depressing is that no framework has been established to provide cheap and sustainable hydrogen energy for the average car owner in the future, for example. Even if hydrogen were now cheaper than a ballpoint pen, it would take years for it to become the most used energy source. However, the irrefutable fact is that hydrogen energy is a renewable source, and it is sufficiently available. There is one thing that is not clear in this implication. Why are the powerful corporations so afraid of hydrogen?